Members of Parliament who sit on the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises COSASE have been called out of recess to handle the matter of government's bid to borrow 508 billion shillings from the bank for construction of the 97-kilometer Lusarira Nkonge Lumege Simbabwe Road. The legislators were, however, surprised when the Minister of Finance, Matia Kasaija, who was expected to appear before the committee, did not surface. Migadi Robert, the vice chairperson COSASE, expressed disappointment towards government ministers who avoid the committee whenever patent issues arise.
Parliament says, so ababaka fefe naba tuje muri ses office ya speaker atugan tulina okola koloni eno genda kuzomweza abiri musatu parliament wedam evident ze ye milimo ekisokerwako.
COSASE members are worried that if ministers continue to dodge appearing before the committee, this loan could be passed by parliament without ardent scrutiny. This poses a risk of confusion and could lead to unnecessary borrowing at high interest rates. John Bosco Ikojo, the COSASE chairperson, revealed that he received a phone call from the Minister of Finance informing him that the officials are not ready to make an appearance.
Tugambye neda, wadenga tulimurisesi nga batuise, tuje, tutunulire loneyo, tujuo obude, nga committee, newe tutuse wanu minister, Minister of Finance, Minister of Finance, and the ministry ye.
Parliament is expected to resume sitting next week with this issue top on the agenda. The Green Schools Initiative 2024 is currently in its second phase. This phase showcases the innovative efforts by schools to mitigate and combat climate change. Today, we are in Western Nile to observe the measures and actions schools are taking to fight climate change. The team of judges, along with members from the FAO, the Embassy of Sweden, and journalists from Vision Group, were in the field to examine what these schools are doing to address climate change in their schools and communities. The evaluation criteria included the school environment, climate change innovations, support from the administration, and climate change club activities, among others. These parameters served as the baseline for the judges to select and award the best school in the region. The five schools selected for evaluation are Arua Public Secondary School, Muni Girls Secondary School, Mvara Secondary School, Bishop Angelo Tarantino Secondary School, and Oleba Seed Secondary School. Speaking to some students and teachers from the Environmental and Climate Change Clubs, they shared their perspectives on the fight against climate change and emphasized the necessary actions to mitigate its effects.
First of all, I want to be grateful to the new vision. First thing I did was that I was not aware that the future belongs to me and I have to care for my environment. But with the new vision, you see that everything was possible. When I saw my colleagues from other schools doing different activities, I found myself getting also interested. I realized that when today I harm my environment, it will cause harm to me. So I got interested in designing my environment.
I think before in the initiative is taken, you must create lessons, good lessons with the students to understand you. That is one thing. Then second is when you come in, you educate them on if you do like this, what is going to be the environment impact assessment here, what is going to be. And then based on the heat that we have been here, we have not reached the level of heat wave, we understand. But the heat itself has been affecting us at the school and then at home.
From West Nile, the team will be heading to Northern Uganda. The initiative is organized by Vision Group with support from the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations and sponsored by the Embassy of Sweden. Vicky Nabumugobe from Sironko has been declared the new Speaker of the Eastern Region Youth Parliament 2024 following elections that were held at Mountain Elgon Hotel in Imbale City. Nabumugobe was declared the winner after beating her contender, Rosta Muzaki, with 58 votes against 12.
I am so grateful for the youth that have entrusted me with their mandate to serve them as the Speaker in the 7th Sub-Regional Eastern Youth Parliament. And in the House, we've had several discussions on motions which have been adopted by the August House. And one of the motions that we have adopted a motion on increment of educational budget by the government.
While delivering his speech during Eastern Youth Parliament speaker elections, Mbale City Assistant RCC Hussein Gadimba encouraged the youth to take a stand in the fight against corruption in the country.
Youth who are here, this country is losing a lot of money in corruption because people are not patriotic. Let us join our hands together to fight corruption.
Youth Chairperson Bulambuli and Operation Manager Presidential Industrial Hub at Luhonge in Mbale District, Philip Waniala, called upon the government to award contracts to the youth who graduate from Presidential Skilling Hubs, saying they can deliver technical services required for different projects in the country.
Now, since these people have the skill, and the media, you have gone there, you have seen what we are doing. It is really commendable work. We are requesting that through His Excellency, we get an opportunity that if we are to build the oil pipeline, we have the youth who have gotten the skills and they can do better.
Waniala also called for interrogation of laws that limit youth national participation, adding that the current youth leaders of the Eastern Youth Parliament should encourage the youth to embrace presidential industrial hubs and other government programs.